I'm Jason Pino. You're watching Science of Bizarre, and I'm gonna get all S&M on you guys. So today we are going to be talking about the 100-foot rope escape, made famous by Harry Houdini, where people will usually 2 to 3 people will tie someone up to a chair with 100 feet of rope, and they have to try and escape within the time that it took them, the other people, to tie them up. I will now show you guys the performance. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but tying me up with 100 feet of braided nylon rope excites me. As I said, it's 100 feet of braided nylon rope. This is important. This is braided nylon rope. This is, I think it's half inch, roughly half an inch. I can't remember exactly, but that's what works best for this, because braided nylon rope does not, you can't really tighten this stuff that much, right? Like if I can pull on it as hard as I want, and it basically just comes undone like that. It's a lot easier. Which brings us to the fact that there is 8,000 different ways of tying a knot. One of them in which you lose 50% of your stuff to another human being. None of them, though, are effective when it comes to tying someone up with 100 feet of rope. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. No matter how good you think you are at tying someone up with 100 feet of rope, you are not. No pun intended there. This rope escape takes advantage of the fact that we live in a society where bigger is better and more is better, when it's actually the exact opposite. Less is actually better. Now, if someone were to tie me up with a shoelace, for example, like this, it would be a lot harder for me to escape from it, because why? More rope will always equal more slack. If I get one of my hands loose, if I get my left hand loose, it basically gives me like another 8 feet of slack when I actually get it loose, because there's so much rope there. This is usually done with 2 to 3 people, and they're people who don't know each other. So 2 people from the audience who have never met, they're 90%, you're 90% sure that they will not work well together. And even if you do it with one person, it's still not very effective because it's 100 feet of rope. So we know that any good knot they tie is ultimately ineffective, but they don't know that. And you have to try to escape in the amount of time it takes them to tie you up, which is another thing about this. If they're going to go methodical and tie these really good knots. This is going to take some time, which gives you a lot more time to escape from knots that are ultimately ineffective anyways. If they're going fast and they want to speed up the time because they're giving you less time to escape, they're going to be a lot sloppier, and most likely it's just going to be a bunch of wraps around your body, which, it's just loops, so it's not even really tying anything off to each other itself or anything like that. And the last thing I would say is egg them on. They're going to be sloppier if you egg them on, because if you're telling them they're bad at tying, then they're going to want to tie up quicker, and because kind of like they get annoyed and stuff, whatever, right? Like another one of the things I like to say is like to egg them on a little bit, be funny is oh, my mother has tied me up better than you have, and then I'm like, oh, just kidding, it was my grandmother, So it just kind of like makes them like, oh, I just really want to tie this guy a lot quicker, and then which like we said, quicker is always sloppier. So we'll finish this up with an obvious safety tip. No, you gotta make sure you tell them no wrapping the rope around your neck.